For this movie, we're going to be looking at the Optimize option within the Width Gradient panel, part of the WidthScribe toolset. The Optimize option here is a tick option with a slider and a value associated with it. Now for many, this can be actually left alone and there is actually no need to actually touch this for most common operations. But when you really start using this tool to the maximum, you'll start finding that the number of width markers applied can get quite high. And because of the complex nature of variable stroke widths within Illustrator, it can start slowing Illustrator down if you have too many width markers. So what this option does is allow you to determine the compromise between accuracy, i.e. many width markers, and efficiency of the actual design. Let's look at this circle here. I'm going to select it. And I'm using a linear mode and relative. And I'm going from 100%, i.e. keeping the same width, up to 1000%, i.e. 10 times greater width. And I'm going to drag a line from here to here. Now by default I was using an optimization level of 3.5. And we can see in the bottom portion of this panel, it states that there are 12 width markers on this path. Let's examine this a bit further using the width tool. And if I hover over this path, you can see the number of markers here, starting here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, going round, etc. Now the tool judged that to create an effect that was actually quite accurate, it needed to apply 12 width markers. But let's adjust this value to the maximum optimization. And what this means is apply as few width markers as possible, but still create the effect that you want. And I'm going to reapply the same gradient. And now we can see quite a difference in the number of width markers. It's gone from 12 to 5. So there are now only 5 width markers creating that effect. Let's go back to the width tool and look around. You can see a vast reduction in width markers. Going back to the width gradient panel. Let's have a look and adjust this to a zero optimization. This is effectively the same as unticking the optimization option altogether. I'm going to reapply the gradient. And now, the maximum of 17 width markers have been applied. And what you can do, if you look at the actual circle, and I do undo, you can see a slight variation between each setting. Each one is a little bit or a little less accurate depending on the optimization. So all you have to think about is that at this end of the scale, at the left end of the scale, the optimization is turned off and it's going to apply as many width markers as possible to result in a perfect representation of what you want. If I go to the other end of the scale, it means that I want to have a minimum number of width markers but still create a close representation.